Let us pray. Gracious Lord, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful morning. We commit our worship service into your mighty hands. Guide us and help us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Opening hymn number 180. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Son of the Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away our sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Receive our prayer, for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Our Lord's summary of the law and prophets. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one, and you should love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the great and first commandment. And the second one is, you should love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets." Brothers and sisters, we have come together to hear God's most holy word and to receive the body and the blood of the Lord. Let us therefore kneel and examine ourselves in silence, seeking God's grace that we may draw near to Him with repentance and faith. You who truly and earnestly repent for your sins and are in love and peace with your neighbor and intend to live a new life following the commandments of God and walking from now on in His holy ways, make your humble confession to the compassionate God that you may be reconciled anew to Him through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us join in first prayer.
Merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you and our neighbor.
We have walked in darkness rather than in light.
We have named the name of Christ,
but have not departed from iniquity.
Have mercy upon us.
We ask you, for the sake of Jesus Christ, forgive us all our sins.
Cleanse us by your Holy Spirit.
Quicken our consciences and enable us to forgive others.
That we may hereafter serve you in newness of life.
To the glory of your holy name.
Amen.
Hear the gracious word of God. To all who truly turn to Him through Jesus Christ, those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, so that everyone who believes in Him may not perish, but may have eternal life. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance that Jesus came into the world to save sinners. If anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous, and He is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Almighty God, our merciful Savior, who of His great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all who forgive their brothers and sisters, and with heartfelt repentance and true faith turn to Him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. The collect for this day, fifth Sunday after Pentecost, Stewardship Sunday. Stewardship, responsible resource management. Ever active God, who has revealed compassion and fullness of life through your Son Jesus Christ and called us to be responsible with the resources available, grant that we may be prudent in the management of resources as people who fear God, trustworthy, and who hate dishonest gain, so that in overflowing joy and rich generosity, we may be wise stewards of your manifold gifts through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. Please be seated. Now the lessons will be read to us.
Hear the word of God, as it is written in the 18th chapter of the book of Exodus, verses 13 to 27. Exodus chapter 18, beginning to read from verse 13. The next day, Moses sat as judge for the people, while the people stood around him from morning until evening. When Moses' father-in-law saw all that he was doing for the people, he said, "What is this that you are doing for the people? Why do you sit alone while all the people stand around you from morning until evening?" Moses said to his father-in-law, "Because the people come to me to inquire of God. When they have a dispute, they come to me, and I decide between one person and another. And I make known to them the statutes and instructions of God. Moses' father-in-law said to him, What you are doing is not good. You will surely wear yourself out, both you and these people with you. For the task is too heavy for you. You cannot do it alone. Now listen to me. I will give you counsel, and God be with you. You should represent the people before God, and you should bring their cases before God. Teach them the statutes and instructions, and make known to them the way they are to go and the things they are to do. You should also look for able men among all the people, men who fear God, are trustworthy, and hate dishonest gain. Set such men over them as officers, over thousands, hundreds, fifties, and tens. Let them sit as judges for the people at all times. Let them bring every important case to you, but decide every minor case themselves. So it will be easier for you, and they will bear the burden with you. If you do this, and God so commands you, then you will be able to endure, and all these people will go to their home in peace. So Moses listened to his father-in-law and did all that he had said. Moses chose able men from all Israel and appointed them as heads over the people, as officers over thousands, hundreds, fifties, and tens. And they judged the people at all times. Hard cases they brought to Moses, but any minor case they decided themselves. Then Moses let his father-in-law depart, and he went off to his own country. Here ends the lesson.
Now let us read responsively the psalm appointed for the day.
The psalm appointed for the day is Psalm 147. Let us read it responsively. Psalm 147, verses 1 to 11. Praise the Lord. How good it is to sing praises to our God. How pleasant and fitting to praise Him.
The Lord builds up Jerusalem. He gathers the exiles of Israel.
He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds.
He determines the number of the stars and calls them each by name.
Great is our Lord and mighty in power. His understanding has no limit.
The Lord sustains the humble but casts the wicked to the ground.
Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music to our God on the harp.
He covers the sky with clouds. He supplies the earth with rain and makes grass grow on the hills.
He provides food for the cattle and for the young ravens when they call.
His pleasure is not in the strength of the horse, nor his delight in the legs of a man.
Let us read
the Lord delights in those who fear Him, who put their hope in His unfailing love. Please be seated. Now the second lesson.
Hear the word of God as it is written in 2 Corinthians chapter 8 verses 1 to 15. 2 Corinthians chapter 8 beginning at the first verse. We want you to know, brothers and sisters, about the grace of God that has been granted to the churches of Macedonia. For during a severe ordeal of affliction, their abundant joy and their extreme poverty have overflowed in a wealth of generosity on their part. For, as I can testify, they voluntarily gave according to their means, and even beyond their means, begging us earnestly for the privilege of sharing in this ministry to the saints. And this, not merely as we expected, they gave themselves first to the Lord and by the will of God to us, so that we might urge Titus that as he had already made a beginning, so he should also complete this generous undertaking among you. Now, as you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in utmost eagerness, and in our love for you, so we want you to excel also in this generous undertaking. I do not say this as a command, but I am testing the genuineness of your love against the earnestness of others. For you know the generous act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. And in this matter I am giving my advice. It is appropriate for you who began last year not only to do something, but even to desire to do something, now finish doing it, so that your eagerness may be matched by completing it according to your means. For if the eagerness is there, the gift is acceptable according to what one has, not according to what one does not have. I do not mean that there should be relief for others and pressure on you, but it is a question of a fair balance between your present abundance and their need, so that their abundance may be for your need, in order that there may be a fair balance. As it is written, the one who had much did not have too much, and the one who had little did not have too little. Here ends the second lesson.
Today's Gospel, the Gospel according to Saint Matthew, chapter 25, verses 14 to 30. For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them, and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had the 2 talents made 2 more talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. And the one with the 2 talents also came forward, saying, Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many, many things. Enter into the joy of your master. Then the one who had received the one talent also came forward saying, Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours. But his master replied, You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow, and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return, I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is the gospel of Christ. Our next hymn is hymn number 262. Hymn number 262. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Loving Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. I am happy to greet you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Today is Stewardship Sunday. The subject given for our meditation is Stewardship, Responsible Resource Management. Steward is a person entrusted with management of another's property. In another sense, steward is a paid manager of a great house or estate. In Genesis, we read that Joseph was a steward in Potiphar's house. So, steward must be honest, faithful, and obedient. He must always be aware of that he has a master. He is under the authority of his master, and hence he is accountable. Stewardship is defined as utilizing and managing all resources God provides for the glory of God and the betterment of his creation. The Bible repeatedly emphasizes that God's servants are to be wise stewards and managers over the resources he provides. The resources may be financial, physical, and human alike, actually belong to God. We are called to be as stewards to maintain and use the resources wisely that God has given. The Apostle Paul tells us that Christians must regard themselves as stewards of mysteries of God, and each of us will be accountable to God. The principle of stewardship is closely linked to the concept of grace. Everything comes from God as a gift, and it is to be administered faithfully on God's behalf. There is both stewardship of personal resources of time, money, talents, and stewardship of the resources of the church and the society. So stewardship entails the responsibility of investing whatever time, talent, and money God has given to us to yield the best returns to him. Every steward should realize that God is the owner or master of stewardship. He only gives all blessings, and we read in Psalm 147 verses 8 and 9, we could understand that God covers the sky with clouds, he supplies the earth with rain, and makes grass grow on the hills. He provides food for the cattle and for young ravens when they call. God is the owner of all talents. Therefore, the word of God says in Psalm 147, verse 11, the Lord delights in those who fear him, who put their hope in his unfailing love. Today, I would like to bring out some of the points about the stewardship from the scripture passages assigned for our meditation. First of all, stewardship is entrusted with responsibility. Stewardship is entrusted with responsibility. Christians are responsible to utilize and manage the resources which are given by God. Today's first lesson, Exodus chapter 18, verses 13 to 27, deals with Jethro's advice to Moses. Jethro, the father-in-law of Moses, visited him after the people of Israel returned from Egypt. While he saw Moses sat from morning till evening to hear the people and judge them, he said to Moses that this is not good for you as well as to the people. Surely both you and your people will wear out. Hence, he advised him to select able men who fear God, trustworthy and honest. Moses selected and appointed such people as heads over the people, as officers over thousands, hundreds, fifties and tens. They judged the people and hard cases they brought to Moses, but minor cases they settled themselves. Sharing of power or decentralization of power is necessary for the efficient administration. Everybody is entrusted with distinct responsibilities to act for the glory of God. The parents have the responsibility to grow up their children in a right manner. The Bible says that children are a heritage from the Lord. So we are responsible and accountable to God about our children. The teachers are responsible to educate the students, the pastors to nourish their congregation spiritually, and so on. God expects everybody to act responsibly, to be good stewards. Secondly, stewardship is helping others. Paul writes to the church in Corinth concerning Macedonia in 2 Corinthians chapter 8 verse 2. Out of most severe trial, their overflowing joy and their extreme poverty welled up in rich generosity. This was possible because they donated more than what they could. Macedonia is the center of the subcontinent called Balkan. As per the records of Herodotus, the kingdom of Macedonia had been established by Perdiccas I. He conquered the plateau of Macedonia in BC 640 and subdued it. In BC 323, when Alexander died, the empire of Macedonia was extended up to the river Sindhu. During BC 167, it became a part of Rome. Among the European countries, it is in Macedonia the gospel had entered first. Regarding the beginning of missionary work at Macedonia, Paul says in Acts chapter 16 verse 9, during the night Paul had a vision. There stood a man of Macedonia pleading with him and saying, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." Paul visited Macedonia more than once. St. Paul acknowledges that it was Macedonians whom supported him in his missionary endeavors. Macedonians were very close to Paul. Sopater, Aristarchus, Secundus, Gaius, and Epaphroditus were some of them. There were women also as leaders of the church. Later on, due to social and political reasons, Macedonia became a poor country. The people of this country went through many social problems. Though they were crossing through many struggles and economic problems, they were first to give for the Lord. They gave more than what they could for the collection taken for the poor believers of the Jerusalem church. Here we find a community going through poverty and sufferings, dedicating themselves to support the ministry of the poor believers. This is true stewardship. We receive the appreciation honest in small things, not when we have every blessing that we would like to have, but when we participate in the Lord's work with what we have now. The Macedonian church was honest even in their poverty. We are called to be the stewards to help the people who are in need. It is the fact that the primary objective of the church assistance is for others. Dear ones, church is the only institution in the world which stands for its non-members. Thirdly and finally, stewardship and the rewards. The parable of talents which Jesus spoke is very famous. The parable aims at becoming an honest steward by enterprising with the given talents rather than burying them under the earth. The servant who increases the talent by his business is being called the honest servant. Saint Matthew chapter 25 verse 23. The master wanted to honor them with rewards. He made them in charge of 10 cities and 5 cities. If we are faithful, we will be put in charge of more responsibilities. Whereas the master called the one who received one talent and buried it under the earth. The master calls him, Saint Matthew chapter 25 verse 26, "You wicked and lazy slave." The one talent has been taken from him and gave it to the one who has 10 talents. We read in Matthew chapter 25 verse 30, "As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." When we look into the parable carefully, in the beginning it did not tell anything about reward. But towards the end, the master gave those rewards as they were trustworthy in the small matter. In the same way, God precisely tests us in our daily life. He watches us that how much we are honest and responsible and accountable in our duties. We are rewarded by him when we act as faithful servants. Saint Paul reminds us of this in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 10. "For all of us must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense for what has been done in the body, whether good or evil." Throughout the Bible, we read that God expects us to act as faithful stewards to fulfill his will on the earth. In Genesis chapter 2, we read that the Lord put Adam in the Garden of Eden to work and take care of it. Further, we read in Psalm chapter 8 verse 6, "You made human being ruler over the works of your hands." Dear ones, we are entrusted with so many responsibilities by God to act as faithful stewards, to manage the resources responsibly and honestly, to bring glory to God. May God bless us with these words. Amen. Now unto God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, dominion and power forever and ever. Amen. Let us affirm our faith by saying together the Nicene Creed, page number 18. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Please be seated. Now let us remember and pray for those who have celebrated their birthdays and wedding anniversaries last week. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Let us pray. Lord, our merciful Father, we thank you for those who have celebrated their birthdays and wedding anniversaries last week. We thank you and praise you for all mercies and blessings you have showered upon them. Deliver them, we beseech you, from all their enemies. Defend them from all dangers to the soul and to the body. Be their guide, friend, and counselor. May they not be led into temptation, but deliver them from evil influences and become witnesses to the God of their salvation. Go before them, O Lord, in all their doings with your most gracious favor, and further them with your continual help. Grant, we beseech you, that they may so faithfully serve you in this life, and they finally to attain your heavenly promises through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Amen.
Let us prepare our hearts and minds for intercession. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity to worship you. Yes, Lord, we are living in the midst of great chaos and in a world of atrocities. We thank you that we are alive in the land of living to serve you and worship you. We submit the present pandemic coronavirus that makes people's life miserable. We pray for all those who are suffering from COVID-19. Lord, please be kind to heal our world. Lord, we thank you for today's message so that we got a chance to hear once again about stewardship. Lord, guide us to be your wise stewards. We pray for our church committee members. We pray for all of our parish members. Bless all of them and keep them safe in wherever they are. We submit all our actions and their families. And once again, let us submit all our needs and thank for all blessing. Let us use the first litany. Response: Hear us, O Lord, we pray. Almighty God, who has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all creation, hear us when we pray, that it may please you to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity and concord.
Hear us, Lord,
we pray. That it may please you to grant that all those who confess your holy name may agree in the truth of your holy word and bear witness to it with courage and fidelity. Hear us, O Lord, we pray, that it may please you to lead the nations in the paths of righteousness and peace. Hear us, O Lord, we pray, that it may please you to guide with your pure and peace-loving wisdom those who bear authority in the affairs of humankind, especially the President of the Indian Republic, the Prime Minister, the Governor of our state, the Chief Minister, and all those who serve in the government, that we and all people may be governed with justice and honor. Hear us, O Lord, we pray. That it may please you to give grace to all bishops, presbyters, and deacons, especially your servants, our moderator, and our bishop, that by their life and doctrine they may set forth your true and living word and rightly and duly administer your holy sacraments. Hear us, O Lord, we pray. That it may please you to bring into one fellowship and union the churches in our land, that together they may maintain the unity of the spirit and the bond of peace and bear witness to the gospel, especially the churches with which we are in full communion, and to guide their councils and leaders, especially the moderator of the Church of North India and the Metropolitan of the Malangara Marthoma Church. Hear us, O Lord, we pray. That it may please you to guide and prosper those who are laboring for the spread of your gospel among the nations, and to enlighten with your spirit all places of education, learning, and healing. Hear us, O Lord, we pray. That it may please you to give your heavenly grace to all your people in their several callings, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive your holy word, truly serving you in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. Hear us, O Lord, we pray. That it may please you of your goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in their transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. Hear us, O Lord. And we praise you for all your servants who have departed from this life in your faith and fear, asking you to give us grace that we may follow their good examples and with them be made partakers of your heavenly kingdom. Hear us, O Lord. Let us pray. Almighty God, the fountain of all wisdom, who knows our necessities before we ask and our ignorance in asking, we ask you to have compassion upon our infirmities and those things which for our unworthiness we dare not and for our blindness we cannot ask. Also, to give us for the worthiness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Amen. Now let us all stand up for the breaking of the bread. How very good and pleasant it is when people of God live together in unity. We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread.
Now by the offering and sacrifice with shouts of joy, I will sing and make melody to the Lord.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Our offertory hymn is hymn number 263, stanzas 1, 2, and 4. Hymn number 263, stanzas 1, 2, and 4.
Jesus, we are saved by thy blood.
Shall we pray? Holy God, who through your dear Son has consecrated for us a new and living way to your throne of grace, we come to you through him, unworthy as we are, and we humbly ask you to accept and use us, and these our gifts for your glory. All that is in heaven and earth is yours, and of your own we give to you. Amen. Amen. Let us all kneel and say together. Be present, O Jesus, you good high priest, as you were in the midst of your disciples, and make yourself known to us in the breaking of the bread, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to our Lord God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and highest joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord. Holy, almighty and everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, through whom you created the heavens and the earth and all that is in them, and made humankind in your own image, and when it had fallen into sin, you redeemed it to be the first fruits of a new creation. Truly holy, truly blessed are you, O God our Savior, who of your tender love towards humankind gave your only Son Jesus Christ to take our nature upon him and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and instituted and in his holy gospel commanded us to continue a perpetual memory of his precious death until he comes again, who in the same night when he was betrayed took bread, and after having given thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, And after he had given thanks, he gave it to them saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Your resurrection we confess, and your coming we await. Glory be to you, O Christ.
Therefore, O Lord our God, remembering the precious death and passion and glorious resurrection and ascension of your Son, our Lord, we, your servants, do this in remembrance of him, as he commanded until his coming again, giving thanks to you for the perfect redemption which you have brought about for us in him.
We give thanks to you, we praise you, we glorify you, O Lord our God.
And we most humbly ask you, O merciful God, to sanctify with your Holy Spirit us and these your own gifts of bread and wine, that the bread which we break may be the communion of the body of Christ, and the cup which we bless, the communion of the blood of Christ. Grant that being joined together in him, we may all attain to the unity of the faith, and may grow up in all things unto him who is the head, even Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, O God Almighty, world without end. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us keep a moment in silence and prepare ourselves to come to the Lord's table. Shall we say together the following prayer, the prayer of humble access? We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs from under your table. But you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and drink his blood, that our sinful bodies and souls may be made clean by his most precious body and blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. When we break the bread, do we not share in the body of Christ?
We seek to share your life, gracious God.
When we lift up the cup, do we not share in the blood of Christ?
We seek to share your life, gracious God.
The blood of Jesus Christ.
the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, the bread of life. The blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, the true wine. Having now by faith received the sacrament of the body and blood of Christ, let us give thanks. Second prayer. Glorious God of all creation, Holy Father of all people, who through our Lord Jesus Christ united all things in his fullness, we join your whole creation in exultant praise of your bountiful goodness. You have now touched us with new life and filled us with new hope, that your reign will come, that the hungry will be fed, the oppressed will be set free from evil, that your reconciling work will be done, that love and faithfulness will meet together, that justice and peace will kiss each other, and the whole creation will be filled with your glory. Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God forever and ever. Amen. The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Our closing hymn is hymn number 287. Hymn number 287. 287. Thank you. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, our Heavenly Father, enable us to accept various responsibilities in the life of the society and nation, that the values of your kingdom be fostered in the world. Lord, we thank you for helping us to celebrate today as Stewardship Sunday. Help us to realize that we are called to be as stewards and managers over the resources you have provided. Lord, we know that we are accountable to you. Help us to be faithful, honest, and obedient in this life, and to bring glory to your name. Loving Lord, we pray for to bless each one of us. Let your Holy Spirit be with us and guide us in this lockdown pandemic world. In Jesus' most precious name, we pray. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us depart in peace. In the name of our Lord. Amen.